Hey my beauties, so today I am going to be doing a full face of beauty supply store makeup. I recently hauled some things to you guys that I want to try, but for my eyebrows I am going to be using the Absolute New York Super Slim pencil, and I'm going to be using the color Smoke, and this is my favorite pencil. I love it. So what I typically do is I just brush my brows. Like, oh, I'm almost done. Okay. I didn't realize that I was that close to the end, but I might have to switch out my pencil because I didn't know I was almost done. So when that typically happens, I just kind of jump from one brow to the next because I don't want one brow to be darker than the other far as like color. So I'm just going to use it until I can't feel any more product. The Ruby Kisses All Day Cover Concealer. This is in the color Deep Honey. And I'm going to use this to carve out my brows. I am using a Wet n Wild small concealer brush. So far, so good with this concealer. It seems to be pretty, not thick, but it's not thin. So I actually like this concealer to carve out my brows. I like that it's thick, like I said. It's not really tugging on my skin. It is mattifying, so just to keep that in mind. It's a nice color. I did share this palette with you guys from Absolute New York. This is their Metropolitan Vibes palette, and this is what it looks like. We're going for a like grungy, smoky blue kind of look. I like this color story. I think it's appropriate for fall and the upcoming winter. Now, as you can see, this palette does not have your typical transition color. That is the color that you use to start off your eyeshadow, and that typically is like a warm brown or like a skin tone kind of color. So the next thing that you need to do when you have a palette that doesn't have those typical transition colors, you need to find the color that is the next best color to use as a transition color, and you need to know how to use it. So basically, if you have a palette like this, use something that you can feel like you can pack it on and blend it. So I have two options here. I have this dark blue and I have this like taupey grayish looking color. I can go in with either or and kind of tap it and blend it out and make it into a transition color that could be my starting off color. It's always a color that you can use, start you off with. It's just how you apply it, and that's when blending comes in. I'm just going to take it and I'm going to tap. This is going to be my transition color, but the way that I'm going to apply the color is going to be really light-handed. So I know it looks a little washed out, but I'm just going to use that and just kind of, you see, I'm just being very light-handed, and I'm not going so intense with the color because this is our starting off color. So I'm just kind of buffing it in, going in circular motions. So if you ever have a palette that doesn't have your typical shades that you use to start out with, find a color in that palette that you can be very light-handed with. Now, if I wanted to, I can intensify this color, but I have another color in mind that I want to intensify in my crease. And I'm going to take this really intense blue right here. This is called Midnight Blues, and I'm just going to build that color up in my crease, and hopefully it'll come out the way I need it to. And it looks like it is. And I'm just lightly tapping, flicking that color in, and everything is going to mesh together. And so far so good. The colors seem to be pigmented. It's a little patchy right there, and that can be for two reasons. Either the color is just a patchy blue, or it's not sitting well on top of that first color I used. And I can make this blue intensify it as much as I want. And also I could have used a brighter canvas. Like, I could have used a brighter concealer to make these colors pop, but I'm totally fine with this. So at this point, I could go ahead and take some concealer and cut my crease, but guess what? I don't feel like it. So we're gonna go in with some shimmer. So I was thinking about doing like a three color kind of look, but I don't know if I'm in the mood. I'm gonna do it. Okay. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna go in with these pretty blue shades right here. Ooh, just gonna swatch them for you guys really quickly. So yeah, I'm gonna go in with those three blue shades. So I'm gonna start off with this one because this one is lighter. So I'm gonna do like an ombre look. I'm gonna do this shade first, then this one and that one. So it could be like you can go on from light to medium to dark. I hate when stuff don't have a mirror. Like, it's 2022. Put a mirror on your palette. Like, what is wrong with you? Yes, this is so pretty. I like this like silver icy blue. Yes, and it's going on really, really nice. It is some fallout, but that is to be expected. I'm not going to take it all the way because we have another color that we're going to be using. But I am going to switch over to my other eye. Oh, this look a little green. I don't know why I thought that was blue. Ooh, I'm just tapping that color on. Oh, skin in my eye. So I'm tapping this color on, and I'm also meshing this color with the first color that we use as well. So I'm overlapping the eyeshadows. And I'm bringing it, you know, all the way. I'm just bringing it in the middle and kind of towards the end as well. And I'm also trying to cut my crease at the same time with it. Give that, you know, crease effect, but I'm also overlapping the shadow. So you want to make sure you do that. If you're going to do like a three eyeshadow on the lid, make sure you overlap the first color that you use, because we need everything to mesh together, because we're going to go right back in that first shade and we're going to blend the two colors together. I'm going back in with that brush. I'm not putting nothing on the brush yet. Actually, I am. So I'm going to take a little bit of the eyeshadow and I'm just going to mesh the two colors together. It is going to create another color by you meshing it together, but it's blended. You know what I mean? And you want to make sure you do that because you don't want that harsh line. You see, that's harsh and that is starting to blend. You don't want to do that. Whether you're using two or three eyeshadows, you want to make sure you blend. See how that's harsh? And it's not, girlfriend. Blend those two colors. You kind of bring in that first color back to life, but you don't want to overlap the second color too much because you still want to see it. I'm just gonna go back through here and add a little bit. I don't know if you'll be able to see it or not because it's kind of blending in with the other dark shade that I use. So yeah, you're probably not gonna, you could tell a little bit, but it's still pretty though. Yeah, I can see the blue a little bit. So I'm just gonna lightly put that in, and then I'm gonna go back in that middle shade and kind of just go back and forth and basically blend everything together. I need some water, girl. I'm thirsty, but I'm not getting up. Okay, so I'm gonna take some of that green looking shade and I'm gonna fill in those spots that's kind of missing. Yeah, Girl, super easy. You guys see how these colors are blending, okay? How they're coming together. And I want to take a little bit more of that blue, just going back and forth. And I think I might add a little black. I don't need to, but I just like smoking things out a little bit. I'm just going to add a little bit. When I say a little bit, I mean a little bit. So I'm just going to add just a tiny bit, just towards the end, and kind of bring it in the middle. I'm being so light-handed. Ooh, it's pigmented, dude. I'm being so light-handed. I'm gonna just start blending out those edges. Now, if I wanted to, I can add some warmth. This is important. Make sure you go back and blend out your edges. You don't want your eyeshadow to look like it's stamped on. So you want to make sure you blend out those edges. But if I wanted to, I can warm this look up by adding a tad bit of like a warm brown kind of color, just like a peekaboo color. But I'm not going to do that because I want to keep it grungy. So I'm just going to kind of smoke it out, blow it out with this color right here. And you know, whatever is in my crease, I'm just going to use that to blend out everything. Just going to use a NYX primer, you know, because I don't have one. Like, I don't have one from a beauty supply store brand, but NYX is at the beauty supply store. So I'm going to try this NYX Bare With Me Hydrating Jelly. Okay, I'm oily, so, it just popped out everywhere. Okay, this is their Bare With Me. The next time I go to the beauty supply store, I'm definitely getting me a primer, okay? But this is their Bare With Me Hydrating Jelly primer. So that's what I'm going to use. The foundation that I've been wearing is from Nika K. I've been wearing their Perfection Liquid Foundation Full Coverage Natural Matte Finish Foundation, and I am in the color Chestnut. I really like this foundation. I don't want to talk about it too much. I'm going to talk about it because I don't want to talk about it too much because I plan on doing like a monthly favorites, but the way things look at it, I guess I'm not doing it. We shall see about that. But anyways, I love the coverage. I love that it's matte. I love the way it looks when it settles on my skin. When I spray it with some setting spray, it just melts. Like, it really melts. I just love everything about this foundation. It's really, really nice for it to be affordable. I just really enjoy this. Now, my pump don't work on this, so I usually just take it out. This is mine. I use it on myself. You don't need a lot, but I tend to put a lot because I'm just heavy-handed. But okay, I'm going to start off with that. If I feel like I need some more, I will add it. I'm just using a Japuness brush. It's really thick, as you guys can see. I just love the coverage on this. Now, I know it looks crazy as I'm putting it on. I'm saying a lot of great things about it, and it's looking really light and yellow. And I'm telling you, when it settles down, it's so good. I recommend to try it. Just give it a try. If you don't like it, you don't like it. You know, it's not for you, but I know that I really enjoy it. And it smells like baby powder. Like, when you first put it on, oh girl, I'm telling you, it smelled like baby powder. I was like, wait a minute, I kept getting a whiff. Girl, it was this foundation. And you don't need a lot. You see how, like, this probably still too much of the way that it spreads across the face. I'm just putting a little bit on my ears. I just love it. I feel like this is a decent match. Nika K has some decent colors. I always look in the camera when I'm doing my foundation. I need to look in the mirror. But they have some decent colors. I've told you guys this before. My under eyes don't agree with their concealer, but I love their concealer for cutting my crease and carving out my brows. That is an amazing concealer. And they have really nice shades. They have deep shades. I do feel like they do need some in-between shades when it comes to their foundation, but I think it's a really good foundation. And that's a lot coming from me because I don't typically purchase foundation. You gotta persuade me to the fullest. because I'm not a foundation buyer. I just use what works for me and I stick with that and I repurchase it. You have to rave about it for me to be like, okay. And it's gonna take me months to a year to get it. I'm gonna be using the Kiss, full cover concealer in the color Deep Honey. I wish I would have got another shade, like a lighter shade to kind of highlight with. I want to say one of you all told me to let it sit. I don't know if you, girl, I can't remember if you were saying let this sit, the Ruby Kisses or the Kiss. I think you were saying the Kiss. I gotta go back and look at that comment, but I'm gonna let it sit anyway. So, okay, yes, I'm going to be trying this out. It kind of looks like the L'Oreal, for some reason, I'm getting like L'Oreal concealer vibes from this. Like I said, this is in the color Deep Honey. So, I'm going to go ahead and try this on. Yeah, I wish I would have got like another like lighter shade. But that's okay. We're just trying it on. I can always go back. It feels, it doesn't feel too heavy under the eyes as I'm applying it. It's kind of lightweight. Yeah. When I conceal, I don't do all that stuff. I just take what is left on the sponge. I just don't. Okay. Let's see. I'm so nervous, like, when I try, like, new concealers. But it looks pretty good. Okay, we gonna see. We still got, you know, still got other stuff to do to see how well it holds up. But, I mean, it don't look bad. It don't look bad at all. All right, this not looking too bad. Look at that. It blended out very well. It feels matte, but it's not like intense mattifying kind of concealer. Like, I was able to blend it out. It kind of like melted in the skin on its own, but it doesn't look bad. But I do want to hurry up and set it. So I'm going to use this Absolute New York HD Flawless Setting Powder in the color Golden Banana. And I told you guys in my beauty supply store haul, I'm like, I think I have this. So yeah, I already had one. I'm gonna see if my mom wants it, the one that I bought. Ooh, child. Okay. Oh, we're gonna see what it do today. Cause if it don't work out with this, then I know it's the powder. So might have just added too much, but just want to hurry up and set that concealer underneath the eyes. I'm going to set my face with the Nika K Perfection Pressed Powder in Mahogany. I have used this plenty of times. I will have everything that I'm using in the description box. And like I said, this is the color Mahogany. This is the color that I'm using. Absolute New York Miami Sunshine Pressed Bronzer in the color Dark. And I've mentioned this and I love it. It's really nice. It's nice and soft. You see, it's really nice and soft. And you can order this on their website. Yeah, most of the stuff I'm using has websites, of course. You can, if you don't have these brands at your local beauty supply store, or if you don't have these products, you can order on their website. These are from INV. This is, in the style Bear, I guess, whatever. The number is 1. But then for my eyelashes, I'm going to use, Sassy Eyelash Glue in Dark. I get this from my local beauty supply store. You can order this off Amazon as well. But I really do enjoy this, here, lash glue. So I'm going to take a smaller brush and I'm going to take that color Midnight Blue and I'm going to blend that color underneath, and I'm also going to connect it as well. I'm going to take this color right here. It's called Fashion Week. I'm going to take that and I'm going to add a little, you know, a little something. And that can kind of like help the inner corner and my waterline in this area right here. I'm just taking a, what's this called? A sponge applicator. Well, I wanted to try out this I Envy by Kiss Eyebrow Top Coat. I thought this was really interesting because it comes in like a nail polish kind of vibe. So let's try it out. Seems like you don't need a lot. I'm just going to put it on my brows using this. Oh, girl, it smells like glue. It says it's a top coat, so it's supposed to, I guess, seal in your brows. This is really interesting. And I wish I would have tried this weekend when I did my makeup. I decided to kind of intensify the contour bronzer section, and I'm going to take this Nika K pressed powder in the color Espresso, and I'm going to take a little bit of that and kind of add it just to kind of intensify it, because I just felt like the eyes are so, you know, boom boom. I just want to add a little bit now. Yes, it's giving me what I need now. I just wanted to add a little bit. I bought this color to use as a bronzer. So far as my lips, since the eyes are so dramatic, I guess we'd be dramatic with our lips too. So I'm gonna go ahead and take I think I'm gonna take blue and black. Take this blue. I mean, you could go in with a clear gloss and that's it, but I'm gonna be extra. So I'm gonna take this blue and this black. I'm gonna take an angled brush and mix the two colors together, and I'm gonna make me a liner out of those shadows. Okay, now as far as gloss, I'm going to take this gloss from Magic Collection. This is from the beauty supply store as well. And this is their Honey Pro Glaze Gloss. Now, from what I remember, this was kind of on the sticky side. So, I'm going to take that. But I'm also going to take a little bit of this Ruby Kisses Butter Bomb Gloss in the color White Lie. Girl, this is my favorite. If you need a pale nude for deeper skin, I'm telling you, this color right here, White Lie. I'm just going to take a little bit of that. Just a little bit. And then I'm just going to get spread it out when I add the gloss. I'm just going to put a little bit of that on the back of my hands, and I'm going to take this lip brush and I'm going to apply the gloss. So you can do this, if you're going to recreate this look or use these similar colors, you can definitely do a regular clear gloss. No liner, just do clear gloss, but I always like to experiment with, you know, other uses of my makeup. So I'm just seeing what it looks like with a more intense look on the lips. Oh, the lips are pretty. And I will try it on with just the clear lip gloss as well. I'm going to spray my face with the Magic Collection 2-in-1 Primer and Setting Spray. I love this stuff, you guys. This is so good. It's like a nice dupe for the Morphe Setting Mist. And I just be going ham, and it feels so good. Oh, it feels so good. Okay, so this is the final look, you guys. Mainly using all beauty supply store makeup. You don't have to spend a lot of money to get a really, really nice makeup look. As you guys can see, like, the colors look good, the lashes look good, the complexion products look really good. So I will leave everything down below so you know what to get on your next beauty supply store run. And you guys, everything just looks pretty good. I like the way it looks. I do like the liner better with this look because I just like that grungy look. But the eyes are giving. I hope this video was helpful for anybody. And if you guys are new here, make sure you guys subscribe because I will have some more beauty supply store content on the way. I do plan on doing another full face because y'all know I got plenty of stuff from the beauty supply store that I want to try. I do want to try out a different foundation. I don't want to keep using the NYX Cave. But to be honest with you, it's so only so much, you know, I can try because a lot of brands don't have the right shade. I do want to try to use concealer, the LA Color Concealer as foundation, so maybe I'll try that. So yeah, but anyways, if you are new here, make sure you guys comment down below, give this video a thumbs up if you like beauty supply store content, and make sure you guys subscribe before you leave, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye.